Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. I'm joined once again by a man who is an expert on the films we're showing this evening. In fact, he also selected them. He's author and professor Chon Noriega. Welcome back, Chon.
Well, thank you, Robert. It's been quite a month.
It's gone fast. Our next film is written and directed by John Sayles, nominated for an Academy Award for John Sayles Screenplay. And the cast includes Stephen Lang and Chris Christopherson, and the title is Lone Star. Now, we love John Sayles around here. He's one of our guest programmers of the past. Yeah. Terrific guy. And this is a very interesting movie. Let's explain a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's a great film. It essentially sets out to give an updated version of The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance, the John Ford film from the 1960s. And that film is famous for the final phrase by one of the editors who's basically thrown away the story that's been presented to him about who really shot Liberty Valance. And he says, when the legend becomes fact, print the legend. And this is a film that's using the same structure of trying to go back and uncover what really happened in the past. What's different is that the view it's taking is a multiracial one for Texas. It includes not just the Anglo community, but also the Mexican-American and the African-American community. Mm-hmm. And it weaves together their stories, not just at a personal level or a familial level, but in terms of how they represent different sectors of society, both business, politics, and the law, and shows ultimately, in a very powerful sense, how they're tied together.
Now, did John Sayles acknowledge that this is kind of a retake on Liberty Valance?
It's interesting. It's so obvious, and yet I haven't seen any direct acknowledgement from him. Instead, he points to the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez, and he's very clear
to say influence.
That this
really?
Was a very important influence in terms of thinking about this film, not just the film, but the book it was based on and the song, the corrido, that is at the heart of that, that he really was drawing on all three of these in thinking through the film. You see a little bit of this in the way that the film is structured around flashbacks, which is a device that is used in the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez, which is largely telling a story in the present tense, but it's through the investigation going back and trying to look at what happened recently from a different perspective. This goes back over the course of about 30, 40 years, and bounces back and forth. And I think what's fascinating about the film is it begins to, through the editing techniques, through the cinematography, it kind of blurs the boundaries between the past and the present, so that you really get the sense that in the present moment, we're deeply bound up with and determined by the past.
John Sayles is a very interesting filmmaker. All of his things are really worth looking at and studying. I think this one in particular, it's got a wonderful cast that he's working with too. Besides the ones we've mentioned, there's also Chris Cooper,
and
Academy Award winner.
Absolutely, and Elizabeth Peña.
Right, who Matthew McConaughey is in it. Yeah, really fine cast.
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look at the film. Here it is, written and directed by John Sayles, Lone Star. This movie was selected for us by my co-host, Chon Noriega, who's been with us all month, giving us insights about the films through the decades which involve Latino characters, subject he knows a great deal about as an author, a professor, and the director of UCLA's Chicano Studies Research Center. So nice to have you here. And about that, that's very interesting, that last line in this movie.
Yeah, forget the Alamo. It's a powerful line, especially in the context of a scene in which Elizabeth Peña and Chris Cooper are acknowledging that they're in fact brother and sister.
Yeah.
And they're going to remain in a romantic relationship,
yeah.
a sexual relationship.
Yeah.
And the way this plays out against the dilapidated drive-in, it's a powerful commentary on the history of film that we've been reviewing over the last month as well. And I think it's interesting. John Sayles talks about the incest theme as really being an individual accommodation to the idea of the incest rule. He calls it a rule rather than a taboo. But I think there's another way we can look at it too, which is it's literalizing the metaphor about business, politics, and the law being in bed together. And in this case, showing that when you have a society, that means that all races are part of that family.
Hmm.
It's a tough message, I think, in the way that it's delivered in this film. But to have Elizabeth Peña in by saying, forget the Alamo, really is a provocation to kind of think through some of these contradictions.
Yeah. Well, let's move on. Well, stick around. Up next, Arthur Hiller directs Alan Arkin. And a very heartwarming story is a Puerto Rican single father raising his two young sons. It's from 1969 and co-stars Rita Moreno. Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. I'm joined once again by Chon Noriega, professor at UCLA and the author of this book, which is called Shot in America, Television, the State, and the Rise of Chicano Cinema. And Chon is also the curator of our Latino Film Festival. Welcome back, Chon.
Well, thank you, Robert. It's been great being here.
We're having a good time with you.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah, thanks for being here. Up next, we have a film from director Arthur Hiller called Poppy, starring Alan Arkin and Rita Moreno. I loved this movie when it came out. Still a charming movie. Let's talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's one of the few Hollywood films that's explicitly about the Puerto Rican community. The others being West Side Story, Young Savages, Cry Tough.
And those were like 8-10 years before.
Yeah, those are almost a decade earlier. And this is preceding Badge 373, which is really a kind of very negative turn towards the vigilante cop genre focused on minority groups. And so you have something that's, you know, you could really call it a gritty urban comedy, starring Alan Arkin as a Puerto Rican widower.
A little bit of masquerade casting here.
Yeah, he's not terribly convincing as a Puerto Rican character, but he's Alan Arkin. And what's interesting is it's one of the few films that it's not about gangs.
Mm-hmm.
It tells a story of a widower who's working three jobs, trying desperately to give his sons a leg up, a better life than he had, and coming to the realization that he can't. And at this point, the film really shifts genres in a way to situation comedy, and that kind of plays out as the second half of the film. Rita Moreno has a fairly small role, and it's in some sense unbelievable because the Alan Arkin character, Poppy, is kind of resisting her romantic overtures,
right.
And it's a little hard to believe.
Yeah, and she looks terrific, as she always does.
Yeah.
Also, you know, you have to say about Rita is that she won the Oscar in 1962 for 1961's West Side Story, but she really didn't make many films after that. And you know, she had to be offered a lot of things, but she probably was that Oscar and just her own good sense. She was very selective about what she did.
Yeah.
So she didn't do many films. So we hadn't seen her an awful lot between in films anyway, between West Side Story and Poppy.
And this is a very realistic adult role that she has in the film. And the film's notable as well for making, it does it in a comedic vein, but making a clear distinction between Puerto Rican and Cuban exile community, showing that not all Latinos are the same, that there are differences within the group as well. And the film uses that in a kind of sitcom fashion to kind of play out the final part of the story as well.
Well, let's have a look. Here from 1969, a really delightful surprise, Poppy.